This is what remains of the convoy carrying humanitarian aid workers. It was clearly marked with the World Central Kitchen logo. The U.S. expressing outrage at the Israeli airstrike behind the destruction and sympathy for the 7 aid workers killed in this attack.
We send our deepest condolences to their families and loved ones.
Among those who died, Australian Zami Frankum. NBC News interviewed her last month.
The situation in Gaza is, as we all know, incredibly bad. It's going to require all of us working together.
In a speech Tuesday, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said his country's forces unintentionally hit innocent people. The Biden administration is among those pressing for a thorough and swift investigation.
We hope that those findings will be made public and that there is appropriate accountability held.
The deadly attack is further igniting calls for a ceasefire.
So quite simply, the only viable way to protect Palestinians in the first instance, but also to protect aid agencies and those serving them, is to bring about an end to the ceasefire.
The Democratic base wants to stop funding for Netanyahu's war machine. So if your question is it going to hurt the president unless he turns this around? Yeah, it will.
The White House says it will continue to press Israel to do more to protect civilians and to provide humanitarian aid into Gaza. And for now, the World Central Kitchen is pausing its operations in the region. Last week, the charity said that it served 42 million meals in 175 days of operations in Gaza. In Washington, Bree Jackson, NBC News.